they were flying for me. And I wanted to wish upon the Milky Way that's upon a falling star. I wanted to give myself and free myself and join myself with it all.
News. This is Doug Poling. What appears to be a terrible tragedy at the Kennedy Space Center. The Challenger with seven crew members exploded shortly after it was launched about 20 minutes ago. It went out of control and appears to have fallen into the ocean. We have no word on the fate of the crew.
It is the worst disaster in the history of the American space program, and President Reagan has declared a week of mourning for the seven astronauts, five men and two women, who lost their lives on their way into space this morning.
The crew of the space shuttle Challenger honored us for the manner in which they lived their lives. We will never forget them, nor the last time we saw them this morning, as they prepared for their journey and waved goodbye and slipped the surly bonds of Earth to touch the face of God.
We remember Dick Scobee, the commander who spoke the last words we heard from the Space Shuttle Challenger. He served as a fighter pilot in Vietnam, earning many medals for bravery, later as a test pilot of advanced aircraft before joining the space program. Danger was a familiar companion to Commander Scobee. We remember Michael Smith, who earned enough medals as a combat pilot to cover his chest, including the Navy Distinguished Flying Cross, three Air Medals, and the Vietnamese Cross of Gallantry with Silver Star, in gratitude from a nation he fought to keep free. We remember Judith Resnick, known as JR to her friends, always smiling, always eager to make a contribution, finding beauty in the music she played on her piano in her off hours. We remember Ellison Onizuka, who as a child running barefoot through the coffee fields and macadamia groves of Hawaii, dreamed of someday traveling to the moon. Being an Eagle Scout, he said, had helped him soar to the impressive achievements of his career. We remember Ronald McNair, who said that he learned perseverance in the cotton fields of South Carolina. His dream was to live aboard the space station, performing experiments and playing his saxophone in the weightlessness of space. Well, Ron, we will miss your saxophone, and we will build your space station. We remember Gregory Jarvis. On that ill-fated flight, he was carrying with him a flag of his university in Buffalo, New York, a small token, he said, to the people who unlocked his future. We remember Krista McAuliffe, who captured the imagination of the entire nation, inspiring us with her pluck, her restless spirit of discovery, a teacher not just to her students, but to an entire people, instilling us all with the excitement of this journey we ride into the future. We will always remember them, and we will cherish each of their stories.
Given the chance to dream, it can be done. The promise of tomorrow is real. Children of spaceship Earth, the future belongs to us all. She was flying for me, she was flying for everyone. She was trying to see a brighter day for each and every one. She gave us her light, she gave us her spirit, and all she could be. She was flying for me, they were flying for me. They were flying for everyone. They were trying to see a brighter day for each and every one. They gave us their light.
The Challenger crew was pulling us into the future, and we'll continue to follow them. We'll continue our quest in space. There will be more shuttle flights and more shuttle crews. And yes, more volunteers, more civilians, more teachers in space. Nothing ends here. Our hopes and our journeys continue.
It was a real pleasure to be at the Cape, to come down here and participate in something that the Cape does better than anybody in the world, and that's launching space vehicles.
It's good to be down here, to be flying a vehicle that we know a lot of folks down here have worked very hard on. We understand it's ready to go, and we're looking forward to going to fly, getting on orbit and getting the secret handshake.
I am hoping that the affliction that Steve Hawley had from the 41D mission specialist hasn't rubbed off on me, otherwise they might throw me off the flight.
Looking forward to going to fly this one. I think we got some real interesting payloads. We're ready to go fly.
I had the privilege of being a part of the crew that made the first landing here at the Cape, and I intend to be a part of the crew to make the first return landing to the Cape.
It's a great pleasure finally to get this far. I'm very proud to be part of the program that NASA and Hughes have put together as their payload specialists.
Oh, I am so excited to be here. I don't think any teacher has ever been more ready to have two lessons. I've been preparing these since September, and I just hope everybody tunes in to watch the teacher teaching from space.
Today we promised Dick Scobee and his crew that their dream lives on, that the future they worked so hard to build will become reality. Man will continue his conquest of space to reach out for new goals and ever greater